Hi there, I'm John Bond from Riverwinds Consulting, and this is Publishing Defined. Today I'm going to discuss metadata in academic publishing. In a recent survey, improving metadata was the top business priority for scholarly publishing executives this year. Metadata, as we know, is data about data. It is more than just keywords. High-quality metadata is essential for properly structuring a website or digital product, and most importantly, for discoverability by search engines. It provides for the digital identification of content and supports the archiving of this content. It is also essential for good business decisions for organizational growth and product development. Metadata can be divided into several types, some of which include structural metadata, descriptive metadata, technical metadata, administrative metadata, rights metadata, and other categories. Whether discussing journals, books, databases, or other educational products, having your metadata house in order is essential. First, follow commonly accepted XML tagging practices is a must. While a publisher may offer its own content at its own website, ultimately the content is used and processed by many third parties, and therefore complying with standards from Crossref, PubMed, ORCID, Google Scholar, and many others, including abstracting and indexing organizations, is essential. Using industry-accepted tagging practices will make the content much more accessible and increase sales. And well-structured metadata in and of itself may have commercial value past the advertising value. Second, automating and streamlining internal metadata practices is an important task for the publisher's leadership to be involved with and knowledgeable about, and not just delegate. Avoid homebrewing your metadata in-house with an individual or group of individuals. While this may seem economical, it will cost in the long run. Perhaps use a metadata management software, or better yet, a metadata management partner. Best of all is to have the software partner be specific to scholarly publishing. The benefits will outweigh the costs. Ongoing changes to standards such as XML, JATS, ONIX, BSAC, the Dublin Core, and many others will tax the resources of even larger organizations. Working with a partner will help the publisher stay up to date with these changes. Other benefits include reducing staff time by not creating conflicting or duplicate data, the creation of higher quality data, reaching more readers, customers, partners, adhering to best practices, and potentially increasing sales, and many more. An audit of your current and legacy products will show if there's room for improvement. What standards are being used, and are they the current versions, are key factors to consider. Are all current partners satisfied with your product's current metadata feed? As the world and publishing continues to embrace AI or artificial intelligence, the proper use of metadata will become only more important. Get involved and dive in, or engage an outside company to give an assessment of your current metadata status. Well, that's it. I've released a new ebook called The Request for Proposal in Publishing, Managing the RFP Process. It's a short, focused guide to this essential business task that associations or societies use to find potential publishing partners. See the links in the note below for more information on it or how to purchase it. Also, hit the like button below if you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel or click on the playlist to see more videos about metadata. And make comments below or email me with any questions. Thanks so much and take care.